For the first time in over 19 months, I was on an airplane flying to an international destination. I was headed to Mexico. When we had arrived, it was late in the afternoon, so we picked up our rental car and drove straight to the hotel, which was located about 25 minutes away from the airport. Hey guys, welcome to another video. Buenvenidos a Mexico. I am in Mexico for the first time. I have been trying to come to this beautiful country for many, many years now, and I had the opportunity to come to San Luis Potosí. My dad has a business trip here, and well, I decided to tag along with him, so this is a perfect time to come. Weather is absolutely perfect, and yeah, we will be staying here for about 5 days. We have a car, so we have access to drive around, see the beautiful countryside, hopefully explore more of this area, see the city, the history, the architecture, maybe even see the people and how they live here, you know. So I'm super excited to share this part of the country with you guys, and I cannot wait to see what kind of adventures we get into.
The hotel we were staying at is the Hilton San Luis Potosí in the city's Lomas neighborhood, located not far from the city center in the higher elevations of the hilly terrain surrounding the region.
Got very authentic architecture, this beautiful courtyard, there's an outdoor swimming pool. Yeah, I am really liking it. I gotta show you guys around this place because there's a lot of really cool, intricate details that typically Hiltons don't really have.
Although I usually enjoy staying in hotels and Airbnbs when I travel abroad, I did enjoy the experience here at the Hilton as it was quite different from any other US-based hotels that I have stayed at. What struck me the most was how intricate all of the architectural and interior designs were.
Interior courtyards and staircases are very well thought out. I mean, just check it out. It's got beautiful skylight and some plant life.
Okay, so we just left the hotel in search of groceries and some food. Very nice neighborhood overall, pretty clean first impressions. I mean, very modern looking, and yet at the same time, you get traditional architecture.
In my experience, the first few moments in a new country are among the most memorable ones. Seeing that we were on the road since 3 a.m., it was great to just step out and enjoy the rest of the afternoon in an entirely new country.
Guys, check out this massive cactus. I have never seen a cactus this tall. Look at this. So far, we're just walking around the neighborhood around the Hilton, just getting a better picture, better expectation of what the area looks like. It's very nice, very clean residential neighborhood. The university is not too far away from here. but I have plenty of time here to explore. We'll get more into the details of what the city is like, what the city center looks like. Walking through these streets, I've noticed right off the bat that there's a lot of similarities with the brands and stores that there are available here in Mexico. It's really weird to see like Walmart and Best Buy, a lot of the American kind of, superstores. But here, I didn't really expect that.
Pastry options, very fresh too. I mean, you could feel it.
You know, interesting experience here at the Walmart. I typically wouldn't go to the Walmart, but this was the neighborhood supermarket here. They required you to sanitize your hands before coming in. They checked your temperature. So they're taking COVID seriously here, and that's amazing. You know, this is really what the world needs to put an end to this pandemic.
After we brought the groceries back to the hotel room, we stepped out one last time for dinner at a nearby restaurant. At that point, I was getting quite hungry and eager to try the local Mexican cuisine.
This
is for
you. Yes, welcome. Welcome.
Never had this kind of beer. Fresh michelada.
This is a courtesy for the chef.
Oh, gracias. I don't know what this is, but it's a courtesy. Yeah, try it.
Croqueta, chorizo español.
Oh, chorizos.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Careful, this is spicy. It's serrano chili.
And the piece de resistance, patatas bravas. Awesome.
Thank you very much.
Gracias. Found this super cool restaurant, not too far away from the Hilton. So we're just sitting here on the indoor-outdoor mixed patio. Ordered some patatas bravas, ordered some soup. So yeah, all in all, pretty good experience with the food, fast service, and it smells amazing.
Got some lentil soup, and they keep a fresh, steady supply of bread coming, which is quite nice.
Well guys, we just got back to the hotel. It was a really great dinner, great food, great service, and really not too far away from here. I mean, literally just around the block. Like I said, you know, today's a very chill day, very laid back kind of a video. I mean, the day started for us at 3 a.m. back home in Indiana, so we're pretty tired. So I just had a drone flight around the neighborhood just to get a better picture of what the area is like. I talked to one of the concierge guys here at the hotel, and he mentioned that there's a really cool park hiking spot that I can go visit that's not too far away. So tomorrow, I really don't have a plan, but I think I'm gonna head into the city center, the El Centro, and just continue exploring. I wanna see the historic architecture, the beautiful city. From what I understand, it's about 25 minutes away by car, so got a car. I'm gonna drive there tomorrow and see what we get into. Aside from that, I'm gonna end the video right here. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Please subscribe to my channel if you're new here. I have many more adventures coming up from Mexico, and I will see you guys in the next video. Cheers.